He disconnects with a lot of family members. And he keeps playing that over and over and over again in his mind. What does this result from? Parental kidnapping. What is parental kidnapping? See, to all you guys, watch this. Parental kidnapping is when a parent keeps their child from the other parent in violation of the parental custody right. That's parental kidnapping. I see guys go through it all of the time and they don't know how to handle it. It's parental kidnapping. Show calls why she shouldn't be charged with parental kidnapping. See, parental kidnapping is literally a broad term that literally encompasses multiple possible scenarios. It could affect state laws, a parent's marital status. See, wherever custody orders are in place, the parent's reason for keeping the child away from the other parents are all factors in determining whether parental kidnapping has literally occurred. Do you have a custody order in place? I was trying to tell Dwayne this a couple of weeks back. What does the order say? Because if she's in violation of the order, show calls why she should not be charged with parental kidnapping and lose her parental rights, or at least lose physical custody. See, let me make this clear abundantly. Some states make a distinction between custodial interference, which is purposefully disregarding custody orders. And parental kidnapping, some states define as taking the child with the intent of hiding them from the other parent. So some states may call one parental kidnapping or custodial interference. In some other states, the term can be used interchangeably. Parental kidnapping and custody interference will mean the same state. So check your state statute. Right? See how your state defines it. Now, there are some laws in place, and I pray that the good brother Dwayne write it down. There's something called the Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act, PKPA. PK, oh, you men should be writing this down if you're going through these situations, man. The Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act. Well, so the Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act, that's literally a federal law along with the Uniform Child Custody Jurisdiction and Enforcement Act. That's the UCCJEA. Once again, that's referred to as the Uniform Child Custody Jurisdiction and Enforcement Act. Why they never told you men about this in court? I thought if either one of you on the court has actually ever heard of these terms. But Eve violates them all of the time. She violates them all of the time. And none of you charge her because you don't know it. See, what this UCCJEA does, it establishes national standards for child custody jurisdiction. Go and read it for yourself. So this literally gives states, or should I say, it basically states that the authority to issue and modify child custody order is given to the state. And that's called the child's home state. Now, according to the Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act, the child's home state is where they live at least 6 consecutive months. And a lot of guys have screwed up on this. Don't come to me 2 years later, man. Why? Because she's already established a residency. So according to this act, this Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act, a child's home state is where they've literally lived at least 6 consecutive months at the time of filing the custody order. So all of these guys, how many guys have come on the call, oh, she took the baby out of state? And I said, what did you do? Yes, it is. Because according to the PKPA Act, you have a right to make her come back. Because that's that child's state of residency. But you just sit there and let it happen. And that law also prohibits a court from modifying another state's custody order unless the child has lived in that state for 6 consecutive months. So if you got a custody order in New York, and this woman, let me put it more realistic. If you got a custody order in Texas, and this woman took your child and went to New York, you can make her bring it back. She's in violation of the order. I don't want to say it. You can make him bring your son or daughter back because she's in violation of the order, but you sit there and you let years pass, then you want to do something. The Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act has been intact since 1980. See, what this does is prevent a parent, like a lot of Eves do this, man. So a sister did last night, man. It prevents a parent that tries to get orders in a different state, that has custody laws more favorable to them. That's one of the reasons where the act is in place. And when you look at history, this used to be a common issue, man, in parental kidnapping. When you look at the parental kidnapping states, the E will leave the state, go and get a law in a different state that's more favorable to them. But they can't do it as much now because you have the Parental Kidnapping Prevention Act. You guys just don't know about it. And you also have the UCCJEA, Uniform Child Jurisdiction and Enforcement Act. I'm going to tell you guys this, man. Intentional, and I pray that you hear me, Dwayne. Intentional parental kidnapping is a crime. There's something known as the Intentional Parental Kidnapping Crime Act. Write that down. Intentional Parental Kidnapping Crime Act. Did you guys know that act makes it a federal crime for a parent to take their child out of the country with the intent of interfering with the other parentals? This happened to JD, man. And I'm trying to tell him about it. Happened to JD. See, and this is very important. While the IPKCA makes it possible to investigate and prosecute someone for international parental kidnapping, it doesn't create a process to ensure the child is returned from a foreign country, and that's a mistake. See, even if a parent is charged under the IPKCA, the other parent may still face legal issues getting their child back. So JD, if you're listening, what you could do was to petition the Department of State to negotiate with the other country. And I believe he said he did that for the safe return of your son or your daughter who's been internationally kidnapped by the mom. Now, only under the sounds of my voice, man, if you think that the other parent may attempt to, do an international international parent-child abduction, and your child has a passport, ask the court to take possession of it. And possibly of the other parent to prevent them from leaving the country with your child. If your child is a U.S. citizen and doesn't already have a passport, you could register them with the Department of State's Children Passport Assurance Program. And that will notify you if someone applies for a passport for your son or your daughter. You understand? And I'm going to hit you with something else. Each state has their own laws for custody or custodial interference or parental kidnapping. So you got to look into your state and see if this has actually happened to you. Say, for instance, Colorado. It allows for an affirmative defense on charges of custodial interference if the child is 14 years or older. Georgia, right here where we are, huh? Georgia doesn't have any laws addressing affirmative defense for custodial interference. Here is actually a misdemeanor unless the parent does it more than twice or removes the child from the state, then it's a felony. So if you're in a high conflict custody situation, some of you guys are going through courts and all of this now, man. You need to develop a comprehensive parenting plan, a detailed parenting plan that is time scheduled. This is a must if you're in a high conflict case where the woman is playing games with you, don't want you to see your son or daughter at a particular time. You got to put that in writing, man. Otherwise, you might be a victim of parental kidnapping. And if you don't have something in writing, then there's a possible risk of parental kidnapping. See, if you're creating a plan and schedule on your own, you got something on the books. Take it to the court. Put it in writing. That's all I got to say on the situation. I'm going to drop a link in the room. See if anyone has any questions. See if anyone wants to speak on it. Slow tonight, huh? Qatar didn't show up. What's his face didn't show up? Jaidir. Benaiah's in the background in Alabama. Link's in the room. Anyone want to come on and speak?
So Link's just went right on. You just went right on past Georgia, huh?
I guess, man. For some reason he likes it out of town. I can't call it. Nine 32. There's no questions. I'm going to be shutting it down, man.
No, I appreciate it, man.
All is good. All is well. The authorized representative came in the room and said shalom 3 times. Okay. No one needed Maurice, man. Shout out to him, man. All right, so when one comes on, I'm going to say shalom, man. I'm going to give you 30 seconds. Then I'm out of here. Deal the Rose representative say the water.
Yeah, where everybody at?
Saturday, man. Party time. Party on the dance floor. All right. I'm going to say shalom, man. Shalom.
Oh, shalom, Mark. Thank you.